or the synagogue. So when we consider our church, he may have been the pastor. So here he is, a leader. And his baby girl is sick, 12 years old. And even in his position, he realizes that among all the things that he can do, he has just stumbled upon something that he cannot do. But what we learn from this man is that he goes to the one that he knows can do something. And so the first thing that we learn from this father is the importance and the strength that it really takes to go to God. You see, when a man can go to God. So here he is, not knowing anything else to do, but he knows that Jesus is passing by. And isn't it interesting how the Bible does not say that he goes to God, he approaches Jesus, and he stands on his feet with his head up. No. The Bible says that he fell on his knees, and he was at Jesus' feet. You see, some things you can't get from up here. You got to get down on your knees. I understand that we're living in an arrogant society. In 2015, we're living in a time where many of us feel privileged. And so then, because we have our degrees, because we have money in the bank, because we drive a certain car, because we're a man or we're a woman, we think that we can approach God. But Jairus, he's humbling himself. Yes, I'm a leader of the synagogue. Yes, I'm a man. But there is something that I cannot do. So what I need to do is get on my knees. And I need to have a little talk with Jesus. Because I know that he'll make everything all right. So the first thing that Jairus, this father, is teaching us on this day is the importance of going to God. Be strong enough and wise enough to get on our knees. America needs to get on her knees. So then that's the first thing that we see. Now, what's wonderful about this text, is that in between, now, I said that I was reading to verse 42 and then I picked up again in verse 49. What we need to understand is that sandwiched in between this story is the story of the woman with the issue of blood.
All right.
And isn't it interesting how it seems that everybody has heard about the woman with the issue of blood? Sermon after sermon, Bible study lesson after Bible study lesson, we hear about this woman. Wonderful woman. But surrounding that story is this story.
Yes.
So then, because this woman came to Jesus, she came to Jesus. Now, keep in mind, Jairus came to Jesus first. Amen. But now, here is this woman presenting her issue to the Lord.
Yeah.
But Jairus is still there, Lord.
Yes.
But no. What we find is Jesus saying, somebody touch me.
Yeah.
She touched the hem of my garment. I felt the virtue go out of me. And they say, well, Lord, there's a lot of people around here. I mean, everybody must be touching you. But no. Somebody touched me.
Amen.
And so then he looks on this woman and he tells her, your faith has made you whole, and she becomes whole.
Amen.
Well, in the meantime, Jairus is still here.
Amen.
Jairus is still saying, what up, Jesus? Can you help, brother? Are you just thinking about the women? So in the meanwhile, here's Jairus here, and someone comes and says, hey Jairus, hey, your daughter is dead. Don't even bother him anymore because she's gone. She is dead, graveyard dead. So Jairus, don't even bother. But Jesus hears that.
Yeah.
Jesus overhears what this man says to Jairus. And he says to Jairus, don't listen to them. Don't be afraid. Just believe and she will be healed.
Yeah.
So look at what this father is teaching us on this morning.